Where did she do all of her volunteering?
Thank you. Good evening. At this time, I would like to invite Senior Class Vice President Miss Brittany Duchamp to the stage for the Pledge of Allegiance while the Air Force Junior ROTC presents our nation's colors. And if everyone can please remain standing until the colors are retired.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Can the marshals please seat the class of 2018? Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Pelham High School as we celebrate tonight's graduation. Let me first introduce our platform guest. School Board Chair, Mr. Thomas Geller. School Board Vice Chair, Mrs. Deborah Ryan. School Board Member, Mrs. Megan Larson. School Board Member, Mrs. Candace Rapisi. School Board Member, Mr. David Wilkerson. Interim Superintendent, Dr. Bexy Cox. And Pelham High School Assistant Principal, Mr. Daniel Alexander. Before we celebrate the amazing class of 2018, I need to recognize a couple of people that I'm sure the community would want to thank. Could Nurse Campbell and Mrs. Walsh please come to the stage? We can make it. We're going to get through this. These two amazing women will be retiring this year and combined have given the Pelham community nearly 60 years of dedicated service. So on behalf of the entire Pelham community, I wanted to say thank you and wish them well. They deserve it, so thank you to them. On the last page of today's program, there's a list of scholarship donors who have awarded $55,000 to this year's class. So please join me in thanking them for all their efforts for this class of 2018. Now, for the class of 2018, congratulations. You've all worked extremely hard over the past 12 years. I want to remind each and every one of you that after today, you will all go your separate ways, but please remember, you will always be a Python and welcome at Pelham High School. This past weekend, I had the privilege of giving the class of 1978, and Mr. Greenwood was part of that class, a tour of the newly renovated Pelham High School. You could see the pride in their eyes as they walked the halls. Someday, you will come back to Pelham High School and remember the good times you had and the relationships you formed. Now I would like to give you some statistics for the class of 2018. 424. That represents the amount of college credit courses completed by the class of 2018. 424. That's pretty amazing. We had 20 students complete a CTE program, a career and technical education program. Out of those 20, 8 have received their apprentice license, and 4 others have completed an OSHA certification program. Congratulations to them. 82% of this class has decided to further their education in a 2 or 4-year college or university. 13% have chosen to enter the workforce, and 4% have chosen a career training program. I would now ask the following students to stand up. Diana Sauer and Nolan Harvey, please stand up. These two students will be protecting the United States of America in the years to come. So on behalf of the entire Pelham community, I want to thank you, Diana and Nolan, for your choice. Please be safe. I'd also like to ask that all military veterans please stand so the students of the class of 2018 can thank you for your service. So anybody, a military veteran, please stand and thank you. Finally, to the class of 2018, congratulations and thank you for doing your part to make Pelham High School the great school that it is today. It is now my honor to introduce Dr. Betsy Cox, Interim Superintendent of Schools, for her remarks.
Thank you. Good evening, everybody, on this wonderful occasion. I stand here this evening to offer you a few thoughts on this very unique occasion in your lives. Just to reflect for a moment, my high school graduation was 45 years ago. The Vietnam War was ongoing and protests were continuous. Watergate was heating up, and we were still trying to get over the fact that the Beatles had broken up. There were many choices to make as a high school graduate in those days, and the choices that I made in my life brought me here to you tonight. This is not where I expected to be, but that's another story. Tonight it's about you and about your choices. Tonight you graduate from high school, and moving forward, you have the freedom to choose how to live your lives. You are no longer required by law to attend school and are free, okay. and you'll like this one better. And are free from the dictates of your parents, assuming that you leave home and are monetarily independent. Do not take this freedom lightly. You will experience both rewards and consequences of those choices. Some choices will open doors for you. Other choices will close doors, and some of those choices will close doors to you forever. When I started back into teaching, after being home for a while raising my children, I worked at John Stark High School in Ware, New Hampshire. There, each fall, the principal, Mark Roth, had the incoming freshmen engage in an oddly peculiar exercise during freshman orientation. He had them write their obituary. Why would someone have freshmen in high school do such a morbid thing? Well, what is an obituary anyway? It is usually the overview of the roadmap of someone's life and often a commentary on the kind of person the deceased was along the way. Mr. Roth wanted his incoming freshmen to think about how they would choose to live their lives, particularly now that they started high school. He wanted them to consider and reflect upon how they would be remembered when they left high school, because he hoped that by making them think from a higher perspective about their choices, that they would see how the little decisions that they made would affect what they left behind, how they would be remembered. So as you leave here tonight, you begin to plot the independent roadmap of your life. What you do now, how you behave, how you choose to fit into society is your choice. Where will those choices take you? Will they help you to get where you want to go? As you ponder each choice that comes before you, will you consider what the consequences of these choices will be? Will this particular summer job open doors for me? Will taking out those student loans open the doors that I want them to? Or will the debt close some future doors that I would like to be able to walk through? These choices and many, many others lay before you. Consider your decisions very carefully and think in terms of doors. What doors will this choice open, and which doors will it close? And do not consider any decision to be unimportant. Every decision counts. A choice such as, should I have that last round with my friends before I go home tonight, could mean the difference between spending weeks in the hospital, years in prison, or getting up and going home or to class or to work the next day. All decisions have consequences. Choose to be aware of these consequences before you decide, not after. So weigh your choices carefully. Consider thoughtfully in which direction you will move. And know what your decisions will mean for your future and the future of others who will be affected by your decisions. Also remember that you must take responsibility, full responsibility for your decisions, and that every single decision counts in some way every day. So good luck. Go forth and make good, fully informed decisions, for these will draw the roadmap for your life. Thank you.
I would like to invite Rachel Day, class salutatorian, to the stage.
Hey guys. So, guess I'm gonna give a speech now. Hopefully my face doesn't get as red as my hair. We'll see. Okay, bear with me, it'll be a short one. I can't believe we made it through high school. We survived. So much has changed in the last 4 years. We came into high school, a high school with cardboard walls, and we walked out of one with glass hallways. While remodeling definitely improved our school, it was difficult to go through school while the construction workers were still building it. I remember in my Western Civ class, I was trying to give a presentation, and all I heard was a construction worker outside just drilling. It was like I'm trying to complete my presentation in the time limit, and all I can hear is it was really difficult. Throughout our 4 years, we endured a lot. Schedule changes, having to take senior finals, huge puddles in the senior parking lot, the pig, yep, the turkey, multiple bomb threats, and Ebola. But also, we had some fun times. We had a really cool hypnotist show. That one was really fun. Spirit Week was really fun. Seniors, we had the theme summer. And I remember walking around the school, sitting in my beach chair, sipping out of a plastic coconut. It was really fun. Haven't stopped wearing Hawaiian shirts since. It was good. Also at prom, Tyler Mercier had a dance-off with Officer Kelly. That was really fun. Loved. I was a witness. It was great. I recently got a letter in the mail from my seventh grade self, and I'd like to read a little bit out of it. I thought it was pretty funny. So it says, "Hello, future self. How are you? In 4 years, you will get this letter." It's actually been 5 years. I'm really glad I got better at math since then, but it's okay. "My life will be so different then. I wish everything could just stay how it is now." Kind of sad, but it's okay. Part of me feels that way now. This is the last time we will all be together as a class, unless everyone comes to the reunions, but that doesn't always happen. As much as I love to hate high school, I will look back on these years and think of the fond memories that I had here. I've made a lot of friends these past 4 years that I never thought that I would have ever talked to. I'm glad I pushed myself out of my comfort zone and I talked to you people, and I'm glad that I got to know a lot more of my class members. Our class isn't that bad, believe it or not. I used to think it was. I'd like to thank you for being a part of my life and shaping me into who I am today. I would also like to thank the faculty for teaching me everything that I know. I'd like to thank the lunch ladies. They let the seniors cut the line. That was fun. The janitors restocked the toilet paper. Couldn't have done it without you. Coach Regan and Babane, you made gym way less crappy than I thought it would be. It was good. And yeah, most importantly, I would like to thank the homies who pressed the handicap button to keep the door open at 7:35 so I could get into the school before the doors locked. Thank you, yes. They were vital in my success at Pelham High School. I couldn't have made it without you. Anyway, I guess I'm supposed to say something inspirational, so I hope we all grow up and care about things that actually matter. Let's strive to be more kind to those around us. Most importantly, let's follow the I care rules posted in the elementary school wall. They state, 1, we listen to each other. 2, hands are for helping, not hurting. 3, we use I care language. There's a little picture of a cat hugging a dog saying thank you. We need to be more like that. There's 4, we care about each other's feelings. Very important. 5, we are responsible for what we say and do. There's that cat cleaning up the spilled something. You remember that? Oh, no, sorry, okay. So if we follow these rules, I know we'll turn out okay. And I'd like to finish by quoting myself in the yearbook. Congratulations, class of 2018.
I would now like to invite class essayist Vanessa Chen to the stage.
I'm not going to stand up here in front of all of you and lie. High school was not a breeze. And I'm not just talking about cram studying calculus tests, pulling our hair out the day before SATs, or even staying up all night trying to finish a Bailey Burton project. Yeah. I'm talking about entering this high school as a freshman, feeling like a stranger, trying to figure out where we belong, what we want in life, and what decisions will forever impact our future. But one aspect that always remained steady was the strong sense of community within the narrow halls of PHS. Now, before all of you skeptics and critics start wondering how I could be possibly telling the truth, hear me out. We are not bound together by common interests, personalities, or goals in life. Rather, we are connected indefinitely through our shared experiences. Sure, we don't all speak to one another on a day-to-day basis. We don't know each and every one of our peers on a personal level. And we definitely don't even all share the same interests, clubs, or extracurriculars. I mean, anyone who would describe me as an avid sports enthusiast clearly doesn't know me well at all. Heterogeneity, sameness, does not link us together. It is the very journey that brought us all here today that connects us. Growing up in Pelham, I have known most of you nearly my entire life. We have seen each other sit crisscross applesauce as we recite our ABCs, lose our precious baby teeth, and learn how to count without using our fingers. We've watched each other learn how to drive, struggled through Western Civ together, and taken the L on countless CP bio exams. Yeah. Many of us have witnessed each other's first crush, our first kiss, and our first heartbreak. We have seen our friends make mistakes, only to recover, and then make all the same mistakes over and over and over again. You know who you are. From the god-awful bus ride to DC, to having to brave the weather as we trudged to our classes in the portables, and even to debating the pros and cons of taco in a bag, we all share experiences, both the good and the bad. Together, we have crushed our final spirit week, danced the night away at prom, and now, as a community, leap into the unknown. And while I know so many of us are excited, exhilarated even, to leave our past behind and start fresh, there is no denying just how big of a change this upcoming year will bring. It's terrifying to know that so many of us will be stepping into something entirely brand new without having the security of what we know, having to create a whole new routine in life. But it's also so immensely comforting to know that all of us will be struggling with this newness together. Taking my first step into grade school, and now taking my last, I would have to say that my Pelham experience has met and even exceeded beyond all of my expectations because of all of you guys. Except, this was definitely nothing like High School Musical. Thank you.
Thank you, Vanessa. I would now like to invite Class President Caroline Jonkis to the stage.
Hi, guys. 4 years ago, we walked through the front doors of Pelham High School ready to grow up, with no idea what that meant and only hopes of who we would become. We weren't nervous, though, because we knew exactly what to expect. High School Musical and Zoe 101 had completely prepared us for what was ahead. Everyone in our lives told us whether we should expect the best 4 years of our lives that we'll look back on as the good old days, or the longest and worst 4 years of our lives. However, it was certain that for better or worse, everything was about to change. Fittingly enough, change ended up being the theme of our high school experience. We made some questionable choices, yes, but those are the ones that became all our best stories. We have been through so much as a class that it will be hard to sum up, but I will do my best to help us reminisce one more time before we go our separate ways tonight. Right from the beginning, it was clear that life at Pelham High School was far from any high school reality we thought we understood. In our first year alone, both the school's python blue and the tarantula escaped and stirred up a school-wide panic. Going out to the portables for class, we had to jump over crazy puddles and walk up ramps covered in ice and snow just to make it to class on time. And if you planned on saving time by bringing all your books, good luck, because backpacks were not allowed. And what other school can say that they once taught their business classes in a fishbowl and had dividers on wheels for most of its walls? Really, the building was not much to look at 4 years ago. In fact, it was basically just four hallways in the shape of a square, which were constantly full since everyone was taking laps and avoiding class at any opportunity they had. But what mattered most wasn't the school's appearance. It was everything that happened within those walls, or lack of walls, that impacted all of us the most. As freshmen, we may have been on the bottom of the food chain, but we were fitting in pretty good. One of our most legendary moments of our class will always be our freshman year Spirit Week skit and the tragedy that that was. Just to give the crowd an idea of how successful that was, our motto became "We Tried." Just to show you guys how far that mentality got us, we lost to everyone by a huge margin and are still remembered for that epic failure. Pelham High School welcomed us with open arms, and we officially survived our first year of high school. If we thought our transition to high school felt like a lot of change, we were in for a real life-altering experience as sophomores. It was time for the classes to move into the addition that we now have and renovate the school we had grown to love while we were in it. Literally, the school was being renovated while we were inside the classrooms. To truly set the scene, I cannot leave out the ever-present sound of construction that could always be heard outside of every dorm window. The lockers had been completely relocated, so it was like being freshmen all over again, not being able to find them on the first day. Basically, we were back at square one. Back in the good times of block scheduling, this was the time when we took Western Civ for an entire semester every single day, which might sound like a fairy tale to the current sophomores. We were introduced to Sharb, who taught us never to take anything seriously, and Bibi, who started our journey to scholarship and helped us cogitari quasi historian. In the second semester, we all learned a great lesson. Everyone knows the saying, when life gives you lemons, make lemonade. But at PHS, it was interpreted as, when a packet of seeds is delivered to the front entrance, assume the worst and dismiss everyone. Personally, I was a big fan of the second version. By the time we started junior year, the only thing keeping the past alive was that the two grades of upperclassmen, and yes, we were officially upperclassmen, had experienced PHS in its glory days. So it only seemed just a little bit crazy when we would bring up the times of eating chicken and pasta every day for lunch. This was also when we lost access to public Wi-Fi and had to use all our cellular data just to make it through the day. But there was a light at the end of the tunnel, because we were finally joined by our good friends, I think you guys know what I'm talking about, the Chromebooks. No more walking across the school to use desktop computers that would occasionally let us down. Now we had our own always with us. And they also gave us the constant excuse to skip class to go to the only two printers the Chromies connected to, if those were working at the time. On a serious note, thank you very much for the Chromebooks. They actually made finishing every assignment 5 minutes before it was due so much easier these last 2 years. Just when we thought things couldn't get any more crazy, we became famous for a pig, which paid our school a visit while we hosted voting in the gym. This was at the same time when turkeys had taken over Marsh Road, so really the school was becoming overrun by wildlife. And finally, our senior year. No more stealing parking spots, we could eat lunch outside, life was great. It was officially the beginning of the end. We may have had a brand new schedule, featuring 8 classes at once, and more new teachers than familiar ones, but we were doing awesome. Everything that we had taken for granted our first 3 years of high school were becoming all of the lasts. Our last first day in Pelham, last homecoming, first and last homecoming dance, thanks to the juniors for making that happen, last powder puff, last time playing high school sports, last time chanting 2018 at Spirit Week pep rallies, and everything in between. Our last year really was our best year yet. After years of talking about it, we made it to New York City for our senior trip. At the end of that day, we somehow managed, out of every building in Manhattan, to have the buses pick us up in front of the one building with armed NYPD officers rushing in. But what matters is we had a great day and we made it back. One of the hardest things to let go of for many of us is Spirit Week. I will never forget all of our amazing murals made by our class's incredible artists, the continued attempts to plan our skit ahead of time just to change it all week long, and the mad rush to decorate our hallways start to finish Thursday night. This was always a week when our class came together like never before. Our senior year skit, we managed to get disqualified for going over the time limit. Despite the fact that we were awarded literally not one single point for over a week's worth of effort, planning, and practice, we still pulled off the win overall. And I think that sums us up as well as anything ever could. No matter what PHS threw at us, we never let it throw us off our game, and we still came out on top. Many of us have grown up together and spent our whole lives in this little town. We've gone through 3 schools, laughed, cried, and been through it all. But now it is time to go our separate ways. We've numbed the pain of tests and essays with countless Python bowls, taco in a bags, slices of gills, and most recently, vending machine runs. Trips across the school to avoid locked bathrooms have become more frequent as the years have passed. We took 4 years of final exams when we only anticipated 3, but still survived. And yet, after everything, it's still so bittersweet to think that it's time to say goodbye to the only home some of us have ever known. It will be hard to survive without 3 Dunkin' Donuts, 3 banks, 4 pizza places, and the Rotaries, but I know we'll manage. Although change is hard, we have been through it so many times. When we came to PHS on our first day, as I said, We were so ready for our lives to change. And I don't know about you guys, but I'd say that's exactly what happened. Our class was the test group of this school district for so many years, but now it's time for us to go out and make the world our own. I would say this is a good time for me to give everyone a little inspiration and try to compete with the awesome speech I know Taryn is gearing up for right now. In eighth grade, we started every day with the phrase, "Make it a great day or not, the choice is yours." Although I laugh every single time I hear this classic line, it is important for us to remember how true it really is. Life is full of choices. We make decisions that ultimately determine the fate of each day, which will affect the next day and on and on. Never underestimate the power of any small choice you make, because it could continue to affect you in ways you never expected moving forward. For the past 4 years, we chose how the constant change happening at PHS would impact us and our memories of high school. By graduating today, I would say you have 100% gone through adversity and survived. And I hope you react to difficult situations the same way we always have. Laugh through the mess, embrace whatever comes your way, and always prioritize your happiness. Most of all, never be afraid of choosing differently than the crowd. Robert Frost once said, "Two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all of the difference." No matter what direction you choose to go, stand by your decision and have faith that the path you are on is the right one. Thank you to every parent, sibling, friend, and all that have impacted my classmates and I before now, and to those that will support us in our future endeavors. A special thank you to my beautiful siblings and my parents, most especially my mom, for dealing with me through all of the class elections, every fundraiser I stressed over, and for supporting me through this journey. This class was blessed with so many incredible teachers and faculty that helped us get here today, and we will never forget everything you did for us through the years. Thank you to our wonderful advisors, Mr. Kress and Ms. Legassi, for helping us get here even though we drove them crazy. We truly couldn't have done it without both of you. To my amazing 6 officers, thank you for sticking with me through meetings on the hallway floors and Kress constantly roasting all of us. To my class, the class of 2018, I am endlessly grateful for all of you. Despite all of the cords, sashes, and pins we are wearing tonight, the most important thing we carry with us today are the friends and memories we've made throughout high school. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to speak today and for all the memories through the years. Through the many class emails, inconclusive Google Forms, and Facebook polls, I can't believe this is it. It has been an honor to grow up alongside each of you and to be your president. I hope you all had as much fun as I did. This group will always hold a special place in my heart. Be kind, be strong, and love as much as you possibly can. I hope you live the life of your dreams. Congratulations, class of 2018. We did it.
Thank you, Caroline. I would now like to invite class valedictorian Taryn Brunell to the stage.
Our world is about to change. We've been anticipating the change for some time now, wearing our college gear, finishing up finals, and saying goodbye to friends we hope to stay in touch with. No matter how ready we feel for this next step in our lives, we must remember to reflect on what got us to this point. More importantly, we must remember to give thanks, live joyfully, and believe in ourselves. Most of us will be entering the workforce or enlisting in the armed forces. Some of us will begin work tomorrow, others in 2 years, 4 years, 6 years, or even 8. No matter what path you have chosen, my message to you is the same. Believe in yourself and embrace every opportunity that comes your way. In third grade, my dad introduced me to a programming language known as Java Judo, and helped me to create a simple computer script that could count to 1 million. As I watched the computer spit out number after number, I remember thinking that it was the coolest thing in the world. I had been introduced to visual-based programming before, but I hadn't really done much with the passion I discovered. Having been introduced to an actual programming language, I decided to begin teaching myself to code. I spent nights at the PC building virtual pets and creating random websites. In the summer of eighth grade, I began watching lectures from Harvard's introductory computer science course and completing the assigned problem sets. The course was challenging, but learning to program was something I really wanted to do. I loved programming, and I wasn't going to let a barrier such as age stop me from pursuing my passion. A lot of times, it can be easy to let fear dictate our decisions, but it is important to remember that it's okay to try things that are new or make us nervous, even if there is a chance for failure. I will admit that I was scared to be the only freshman girl in my intro to programming class. I was scared to take level one honors in AP courses. I was scared to release my first app on the Google Play Store. And I was really scared to retake my driving test on a stick shift after I failed the first time. Looking back, I'm glad that I took advantage of these opportunities, even though they seemed impossible at first glance. My only regret is for the things that I could have tried, but didn't because of fear. As we move on to new pursuits, we need to remember not to focus on barriers to our dreams, such as grades and age. It is confidence in ourselves that will make the difference. Whether you are passionate about technology, writing, cars, or art, let your passion guide you to new opportunities. Explore every curiosity that comes your way, even if you are tempted to suppress it. You just might discover a passion for something that you never even considered before. If we can find joy in the little things, whether we are striving to understand the derivation of a mathematical formula or the cause of a historical event, we will find joy in all things. Life might not always go the way we want, but if we have joy and know how to find it, we can have satisfaction no matter what our circumstances are. Remember to be thankful for all of the small moments as well. Think about all the people you have encountered throughout the past few years, such as those friends who are always willing to proofread an essay, and that teacher who is willing to answer all of your questions, no matter how obscure they may have seemed. I know that I am not speaking for myself alone when I say that without my family, friends, mentors, and teachers, I would never have been able to get on the path to achieving my dreams. In these upcoming months, it will be easy to lose perspective and to become consumed by our daily struggles and routines. But we need to remember that our worldly struggles are not what will matter in 5 years, 10 years, or even in eternity from now. No matter how much more glorious the future may appear, today matters. College will have its ups and downs, just like high school, and there will always be new challenges to face and new friends to meet. But if we ground ourselves in knowing that there is more to this life, that life isn't just about stress and being successful, and that we have a purpose, we can find joy and peace and love like we never knew existed. We are now venturing out into the world to pursue our passions on a much larger scale. As you walk out of high school and into your future, remember above all that you matter. Even if you are not a Christian, allow me to share a Bible verse that has meant a lot to me. Philippians 4:6-7 says to be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. The foundational meaning behind this verse represents truth for all. If we have joy in today, and continually rejoice with thanksgiving, we will be filled with an unimaginable peace, no matter our circumstances. I only wish that I had realized this sooner, and I hope that you can take my message with you as we depart. In conclusion, I would like to thank my family for all of the support they have given me, my teachers for helping me to succeed, and God for keeping me grounded and reminding me of my true purpose in life, to encourage and inspire others. Thank you all as well for everything you have done for me. Be filled with joy as you leave today, remembering that no matter what the future holds, You have the power to live in the moment and make the most of every day. Thank you.
I'd like to invite Mr. Geller. Mr. Geller, as chairman of the Pelham School Board, I present to you the graduating class of 2018 and certify as principal of Pelham High School that these students have successfully met the graduation requirements as set forth by the Pelham School Board. And at this time, I would ask the marshals to please prepare the class to receive their diplomas.
If everyone could stay in front of the stage for pictures, that would be great. Thank you. Caroline Grace Jonkus, University of Rhode Island. Brittany Ducharme, High Point University. Elena Masterson, Franklin Pierce University. Samantha Egan, Clark University. Amira Eid, Colby Sawyer College. Laura Schelling, University of Vermont. Taryn Brunel, MIT. Rachel Day, Brigham Young University, Idaho. Vanessa Chen, University of Massachusetts at Lowell. Adam James Abramson, Workforce. Dylan Andrews, Nashua Community College. Frank Ball, Nashua Community College. Isabel Balzanelli, participating in Outreach 360, A Year in Haiti. Christopher Barslow, Nashua Community College. Hannah Rose Baudette, Quinnipiac University. Hannah Bedard, New England School of Photography. Haley Belanger, University of New Hampshire. Dorati Pankaj Bhagat, Syracuse University. Jessica Avery Blanchard, Keene State College. Samuel Blanchard, Southern New Hampshire University. Ethan Bovair, Keene State College. Scott Bowden, University of Massachusetts at Lowell. Cameron Brady. Peter Brody, University of New Hampshire. Aaron Buck, Simmons College. Caitlin Burgess, University of Tampa. Madison Burke, LaSalle College. Matt Kamir. Nicole Rose Carignan, University of South Florida. Malaysia Chow Sar. Elizabeth
Justin
Charbonneau,
Stephen
University
Buchanan.
Of Rhode Island. Joshua Cloutier, Middlesex Community College. Cassandra Cogley, Plymouth State University. Darren Colarusso, New England Institute of Technology. Conrad Kuchu. Dakota Cummings, Nashua Community College. Tyler Cummings, Southern New Hampshire University. Emma Cousteau, Sacred Heart University. Jacob Dollinger, Emmanuel College. Victor D. Acevedo, Nashua Community College. Emily Demers, Middlesex Community College. Kristen Demers, St. Anselm College. Dylan DePoto, Assumption College. Matt DiPrizio, Southern New Hampshire University. Jacob Dorman, Riviera University. Jack Drolet, Southern New Hampshire University. Autumn Ray Dufault, Workforce. Avery Duggan, Riviera University. Matea Dumdy, Butler University. James Ennis, University of New Hampshire. Jamie Margaret Erickson, Riviera University. Hannah Fall, Southern New Hampshire University. Holly Catherine Fiola, LaSalle College. Abigail Jade Ferreira, sorry. Sophia Elizabeth Ferreira, Southern New Hampshire University. Cassandra Brittany Figueroa, Riviera University. Hannah Cynthia Flynn, University of Massachusetts at Lowell. Jessica Fox, Plymouth State University. Brooke Frazier, Montserrat College of Art. Angela Garozzo, St. Anselm College. Kira Garrett, Roger Williams University. Mr. Tom Geller will be presenting his son's diploma to Sean Frost Geller, Nashua Community College. Alyssa Gettings, Southern New Hampshire University. Aurora Hope Glore, Montserrat College of Art. Amy Nicole Granfield, Riviera University. Jordan Grant, University of New Hampshire. Connor Dennis Grosso, Southern New Hampshire University. Ethan Greenwood, Wentworth Institute of Technology. Joseph Groh, Wentworth Institute of Technology. Paige Nicole Hamill, High Point University. Carson Hansford, University of New Hampshire. Eric Hardy, University of New Hampshire. Nolan Harvey, University of New Hampshire, Army ROTC. Connor Haverty, Merrimack College. Brendan Hazelwood. Mia Herling, University of Massachusetts at Lowell. Daniel Higgins, Manchester Community College. Kaylee Rose Hyder, Colby Sawyer College. Alyssa Janik, Sacred Heart University. Rachel Jones, Empire Beauty School. Cole Judkins Lowe. Jake Caron, Franklin Pierce University. Mackenzie Kozak, Emmanuel College. Carly Kudalis, Post University. Caitlin LaFontaine, Newberry College. Trevor Lamirez. Megan Joan Landry, Stony Brook University. Catherine LaRochelle, Lakes Region Community College. Peter Diggy Lawson, Franklin Pierce University. Cheyenne Monet Lee, Johnson and Wales University. Sunny Lee, Wentworth Institute of Technology. Robin Luderitz, University of New England. Callie Lindsay, Stonehill College. Antonio Mafera, Workforce. Nia Manjunath, Babson College. Bo McCabe, Riviera University. Benjamin McCabe, University of Massachusetts at Lowell. Alexis McGarry, University of New Hampshire. Tony Mendez, Workforce. Tyler Mercier, Nova Southeastern University. Monique Millette, University of New England. Melissa Molitary, Southern New Hampshire University. Allison Muller, Southern New Hampshire University. Justin James O'Connor, Suffolk University. Brandon O'Grady. Ryan Orlando, University of Massachusetts at Lowell. David Alexander Osorio, Plymouth State University. David Elias Ojami, University of New Haven. Aaron Parody, Worcester State University. Ben Pelletier. Shana Petrillo, Southern New Hampshire University. Aislinn Plumley, Mount Holyoke College. Matthew Poff, St. Joseph's College. Christina Porneris, University of Massachusetts at Lowell. Lauren Putnam, Riviera University. Brad Rideout, Keene State College. Caitlin Reardon, University of New England. Alexander Roderick, Keene State College. Stephanie Rossmeisel, Salem State University. Christopher Rossi. Natalie Rudy, New Hampshire Technical Institute. Mitchell Rufiage, Lakes Region Community College. Ian Ruth, Workforce. Mrs. Deborah Ryan will be presenting her son's diploma to Robert Ryan, Workforce. Thomas Sacco. Diana Sauer will be entering the Air National Guard. Andrew Schuler, Nashua Community College. Bryant Lamont Scott. Brooklyn Shea. Alexis Rose Silvestri, Empire Beauty School. Danielle Sarois, Southern New Hampshire University. Anthony Snyder, Rochester Institute of Technology. Christopher Patrick Susi, University of New Hampshire. Fred Stamatatos, Nashua Community College. Cameron Starr, Quinnipiac University. Anthony Supa, Workforce. Carter Thompson, Lakes Region Community College. Sabrina Tierney, Keene State College. Brianna Trudell, Plymouth State University. McKenna Tucci, Southern New Hampshire University. Zachary Vodder, Vermont Technical College. Connor Viger, Riviera University. Haley Vinciguerra, University of New Hampshire. Caitlin Vinoris, Keene State College. Derek Wenzel, Riviera University. John Williams, Nashua Community College. Michael Yetton, Universal Technical Institute. Roger John Yost. That was great. We have one more piece of business. I'd like to invite the senior class officers to the stage. We have one more thing to do. If the class of 2018 can please stand. Are we ready? Congratulations. 1, 2, 3. You're graduated. Congratulations, class of 2018.